during my tenure as Senator Fernandi, I took great exception to the prevailing cases of historical land injustices meted down upon the Nandi people by the colonial government and its post-independent successors. Inspired by this newfound cause, I sought election as governor for Nandi with a promise to address the historical injustices question, forming a key pillar in my manifesto. This agenda item resonated well with the residents of Nandi, who overwhelmingly gave me this mandate and elected me as their second governor. Upon my inauguration and assumption of office, my administration immediately set out to take stock of the exact extent and the nature of the historical claims. This quick and cursory review of the county's status revealed a rot in the allocation of leases, renewal of these leases, a betrayal of the promise to squatters, and the apparent alacrity to the plight of the landless and forest evictees in our county. In line with my mandate and the authority as set out by the law, I sought to marshal the county resources to remedy the situation. I used the government approach and committed under the banner of the National of the Land Rights and Land Injustices Program. This program was launched on 15th of March 2018 at Nandi Bears Club in Nandi Hills. At this forum, I laid out to present a comprehensive plan affirming my commitment to this agenda of addressing historical injustices. The highlight of this plan included the expansion of the county law office to accommodate the advocacy agenda with the mandate and the capacity to offer a listening ear and counsel to historical land injustices victims in our county. In unison and in one voice, all those in attendance agreed to this new bold vision and culminated in the signing of the third Nandi Hills Declaration on 15th of March 2018. With the Nandi Hills Declaration as a guiding vision, my administration set out an advisory technical committee and extended the services of the county law office administered and resourced by the lands department. Here, all claims and their unique claims have had the opportunity to document and collate their claims for presentation to different forums. The forums that we used are the National Land Commission, the Ministry of Lands, the Kenya Forest Service, the Ministry of Agriculture and its agencies, Privatization Task Force, and Direct Interventions. In all these forums, we have seen great milestones and seen great successes, such as the gazettement of favorable findings by the National Land Commission on 1st of March 2019. This was after extensive tour and hearings of the affected groups and hearing sessions within Nandi and outside Nandi. These claimant groups now await implementation of the National Land Commission findings. This journey has not been without challenges. Many of our detractors and the beneficiaries of historical injustices have attempted to derail our efforts through pointless, useless legal challenges. Towards this, we have had to instruct advocates and councils to quickly dispense with some of these legal obstacles. We remain hopeful for a quick restoration of justice, because justice delayed is justice denied. Now to our most recent success story. and the reservation of land reference number 7057 for the settlement of squatters by the National Land Commission, I would like to highlight the following and make a few observations. That within the Chemelil area of Nandi County, 6 parcels of land have had their leases lapsed. These leases were under the umbrella of Chemelil Saison Farms. These parcels of land include LR number 1467/8, 1467/9, 5488/83, 7057, 6076, and 10264/2. What is strange about this is that on the very eve of our administration's inauguration into office, there was a concerted and a clandestine attempt to renew these leases without the involvement of the county government and the squatters on ground. Upon discovery of these acts, my administration took a swift action to intervene through a series of correspondences and flex our authority to cancel those leases. I am pleased to announce this morning that through a letter dated 9th of February 2021, the chairman of the National Land Commission, Mr. Gerishom Otachi, wrote to the CS in charge of lands, Farida Karonei, communicating the decision to reserve land reference number 7057, which measures 1,440 acres for settlement of squatters as requested by the county government of Nandi. As a county administration, we welcome this decision and ask the National Land Commission, the Ministry of Lands, to expedite the process to process title deeds and allocation for these squatters in those places. However, my administration and I, this is only but the start in our commitment to our vision of ensuring that we address all historical injustices as captured in our third Nandi Hills Declaration. To our brothers in Nyando Valley Association, Nandi Timur, Titan Squatters, Tanzania Returnees, Soy Mining Squatters, Kapsiri Choi, Nandi Royal Trust, Timoni Mein Kejire Team, Dengerek, Koibem Squatters, Kiptui and the Robos, of Serengoni, Kisabei, Angati Kong, Talai of Nandi, Kipkoimet Squatters, Set Karoi Squatters, Kisoche Kas Squatters, Tartar Squatters, Kiboji Squatters, Kibabet Southeast Corner Squatters, Kiptega Squatters, Chebonet Guruni, Chebonet Squatters. Just to mention a few groups, we want to tell you we are handling your cases just like we are handling the Chemelil squatters one. And we have agreed today that we have developed a one-month program to ensure that we take stock and review the progress and develop the next course of action. I call upon all of you to join the Chemelil in celebrating this milestone as we push for our cases, because we have to ensure and we realize that our fate is tied. Until there will be no justice in Nandi, until all the squatters have had justice to them. The journey to land justice is long, sometimes difficult, windy, but I ask for your patience, commitment, and prayers as we push and fast-track the process. God bless you. And God bless Nandi County.